Hello everyone, today we will discuss a mechanism of muscle contraction. Mechanism of muscle contraction. So the mechanism of muscle contraction, a previous class discuss excitation of muscle and formation of cross bridge. So the mechanism of muscle contraction, totally 5 steps. First one, excitation of muscle. Second one, formation of cross bridge. Third one, power stroke. Fourth one, recovery stroke. Fifth one, relaxation of muscle. Relaxation of muscle. First two steps, excitation of muscle, discuss in previous class. Next one, formation of cross bridge, discuss in the previous class. Today, discuss third one. Third one, power stroke. Third one, power stroke. So the power stroke, so the cross bridge formation, previous class second sliding formation of cross bridge. See the diagram. So these are the two actin filaments. So they are the myosin. So the myosin head, myosinate is a binding. So the 50% of myosinates are presenting on the one Z line. So these are the Z line. So they are the another Z line. Another Z line. So the 50% of myosinates binding of the one side of the Z line. So the another 50% of myosin heads binding to the opposite direction. So they are the opposite direction. So the myosinates, the binding to the actin filament. So they are the myosin filament. So they are the actin filament. So the myosinate binding to the actin filaments. So the myosinate binding to the actin filaments. So these are the Z line. So these are the Z line. So they are the actin filament. So they are the myosin filament. Myosin filament. So these are the sliding filament theory. These are the Z line. So these are the Z line. These also Z line. Next one. So these are the I band. I band. So these are the A band. Next one, so these are the H zone. These are the H zone. H zone. So these are the same. So they are this like structure. Like so the myosin heads. Like just so these are the myosin head binding to the actin filaments. So the first step, power stroke. So the power stroke means the myosin head binding to the actin filament. So these pulling the myosin heads pulling the pulling towards towards the A band. So the myosin head binding to the actin filaments. So this myosin head pulling. So the 50% of myosin head is presenting on the one Z line. So the 50% of myosin head is presenting on the another Z line from the same sarcomere. So they are the sarcomere. So they are the sarcomere. So they are the same side. So they are the pulling from the 50% myosin heads pulling to this side. 50% myosin heads pulling to the in this side. So these are called as power stroke. The myosin heads pulling the one side. 50% is pulling from the AZ. So they are the A band. Like the A band side. So the another myosin heads pulling from the A band side. So they are decreasing. Next one. So these are the decreasing in size. So the myosin heads in this size. So they are the moving from the A line side. So these opposite myosin heads, they are pulling to the opposite A membrane. So the decreasing of the size of sarcomere. Decreasing of size of sarcomere. Size of sarcomere is called contraction. Understand? So the first step, so the myosin heads, they are pulling to the A band side. So they are the A band. So they are the pulling through the in this side. So they are moving from the in this side. So the two Z lines. So the actin filaments attached to the Z lines. Actin filaments. Attached Z line. So the actin filaments are the moving this side, A side. So the in this side actin filaments are the moving to the A side. So the along with actin filaments, the Z membrane, Z line also moving this side. So the A membrane side, the Z line also move to the A band side. So the otherwise Z line is also move to the A band side. So they are the decreasing of the size of muscle is called as contraction. The same, see this diagram. So these are the size. So the sarcomere size is decreases. The size is decreases. So the normal and the resting size, in this size is the resting phase. So in the contraction size, so the decreasing of the size is called as contraction, is called as power stroke. Next one, I band size or length is decreased. Is decreased. And sarcomere size or length is decreased. Size is decreased. And H band size, H zone size, H zone size is decreased. H zone size also decreased, but A band size is normal. A band size is not, does not change. So they are the A band size is does not change because of only the thin filaments. The filament means the A bands are, the I bands are moved to the inner side of the A band. So in this side A bands are move in this side, in this side A bands are the move in this side. So the A band size is does not decrease, only decreasing of the I band size. So they are the decreasing only I band size and decreasing of the H zone, decreasing of the H zone. So they are the I band. So these are the H zone. So the A band size does not decrease. A band size is does not decrease. A band size does not decrease because of A bands are the normal position. So the A bands contain myosinates. The myosinates is the normal position in this size. So the contraction, they move to this side. So the myosinates are the like this. So the contraction time, these myosinates are the move to in this side. So the in this side Z line move to in this side Z line is move to the A band side. So the muscle size is decreases. Muscle normal size is. So the myosinates are binding to the actin filaments. The myosinate move to this side. So the Z line, this Z line move to the A band side. In this side Z line move to the A band side. So the size is decreases. So these are called as contraction. So they are called as contraction. So they are the power stroke. In the power stroke, the myosin head. So the myosin head, in these are the myosin head pulling up the A band side, pulling up the A band size. So the thin filaments are the inwards. Z line also move to the A band size. So the size is decreases, is called as contraction, is called as contraction. So the decreasing of the I band size, length, I band size is length is decreases or size is decreases. H zone size also decreases, but A band is normal for size and normal length. A band is normal size or normal length. Next one, third one after fourth one. Fourth one, recovery stroke. Fourth one, recovery stroke. Fourth one, recovery stroke. Fourth one, recovery stroke. So the recovery stroke means, so the myosin heads, so the myosin heads are the relaxed. The myosin head is 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 relaxed and releasing ADP. Releasing ADP. The myosin heads are the relaxed. So the myosin heads are the relaxed, releasing to the ADP. Next one, the myosin head binding to the another ATP. Myosin head bind another ATP. The myosin head binding to the another ATP. So the these ATP utilization of energy, binding myosin utilizing energy myosin binding site of binding site of actin attached myosin head. So first step, the myosin head is relaxed. Relax means the bond is removing. Actin myosin binding is a power stroke is formation of cross bridge is relaxed. So the releasing of the ADP. So the another ATP is attached. The utilization of energy, the myosin head binding to the actin filaments. So the once again pulling the towards the A band. So the size is again decreased. So these are called as recovery stroke. Simple recovery stroke means first the myosin heads are the relax. The myosin head releasing the ADP. So the another ATP binding to the ATP binding site of the myosin head. So the myosin head utilization of the ATP. The myosin head binding to the another place of the actin filaments. So they moving to the inwards. So the moving toward the A band size. So the size is decreases. So these are called as recovery stroke. Next one, final fourth one, relaxation of muscle. Fifth one, relaxation of a muscle. Fifth one, relaxation of muscle. Simple, the relaxation of muscle, the first step, the central nervous system stopping action potentials. So the central nervous system stopping the action potentials. So the calcium ions move to the sarcoplasmic reticulum. So the first step, the messages are stopping from the central nervous system. The calcium ions are moving from the sarcoplasmic reticulum of the cistern. So the calcium ions are not available. So the troponin and tropomyosin masking up myosin binding site of actin myosin binding site of actin. So the calcium ions are the moving from the sarcoplasmic reticulum. So the calcium ions are not available. So the masking of the myosin binding site. So the myosin binding site, the masking. So the myosin head does not binding the actin filaments. The myosin head does not binding to the actin filaments. So the muscle is relaxed. The muscle is relaxed. So these are called as relaxation of muscle. In the first step, the masking of troponin and tropomyosin. So the calcium ions are coming. So the calcium ions binding from the troponin C. So the unmasking of the actin binding site of the myosin. So the calcium ions are coming. So the binding of the troponin, change in the position. Change in the position means the myosin binding site is exposed. Myosin binding site is exposed. The myosin head binding to the actin filament. So the muscle is contraction. So the calcium ions are the moving from the sarcoplasmic reticulum. So the calcium ions are not available. So the troponin and tropomyosin is unmasking a myosin binding site. Unmasking of the myosin binding site. So the myosin head does not binding to the actin filaments. So the muscle is relaxed. The muscle is relaxed. So these are called as muscle contraction. So the muscle contraction proposed by, explained by the sliding filament theory. So it is proposed by the two scientists, Jan Hansen and Hugh Oxley. So they are presenting on the five steps. First one, excitation of muscle. Second one, formation of cross bridge. Third one, power stroke. Fourth one, recovery stroke. Fifth one, relaxation of muscle. So these are the mechanism of muscle contraction.